Hey guys, Chris from Hockey Tutorial here, and today this is a video that you guys have requested. I've seen so many requests on the podcast and also the reviews that we've done on the Ultrasonic Skates and the AS3 Pro that you guys wanted to see them put together in a head-to-head. I just wanted to preface this by saying that this isn't a very easy video to shoot, now more so than ever before because of this new fit system from Bauer. So there is a lot of differences between these two skates, and them both being from a fit family that traditionally was quite similar in terms of the fit that it offered the player. Now we know that's a little bit different depending on what fit you're going for with one over the other. I just had to preface this video by saying that these skates have different technologies, they have different features, they have different, I guess you could say, advantages that fit different types of players. Now, I can't really sit here and tell you one skate is better than another, because realistically, we all know that it comes down to personal preference and, of course, what fits your feet the best. That's what really needs to dictate which skate you go for, as well as which skate is going to allow you to perform to the best of your ability on the ice. So I had to mention that before we jump into this, and everything you hear in this video is going to be based on my experience and my personal preference over different technologies over another. So just bear that in mind. This is going to be a very opinion-based video, but please leave your comments down below on if you think that another element of a skate is better than another, like for example, runner versus runner, which one has the better one. Leave your comments down below as I go through the video, letting me know which one you think is better, and most importantly, tell me why. Before we jump into the video, make sure you thumbs up and subscribe so you can stay up to date with all of the videos that we post. But let's jump into this tricky video, and I'll share as much as I can. Now, starting off at the bottom of the skate, as we always do, I'm going to be kicking this video off by looking at the AS3 Pro from CCM. We're going to be looking at the runner that that skate has, which is the XS1 Black. That black coating, as we all know, as I'm sure, is there to not only look better, but it has a few performance benefits. It's able to hold its edge life a little bit better than your traditional stainless steel, and it'll also generally be able to withstand the wear and tear of the game a little bit better. That black coating genuinely does give you a small advantage in terms of its edge life, its edge retention, and how easy it is to sharpen the blade as well. And it also doesn't require honing, which is always a bonus when you're looking at runners. Now, how that compares to a traditional blade, all I'm saying is that that just means that you're going to essentially have less trips to the pro shop, and while you're on the ice, it's going to hold its edge a little bit better than a blade that you might have had previously. Now, when we look at Bauer's runners that are featured on the Ultrasonic Skates, these feature Bauer's new titanium-coated blades. Now, it sounds pretty cool, and I'm not going to lie, if we're looking at it from a very visual perspective, the titanium-coated blade looks better than the XS Black. That's just, you know, my opinion. Let me know what you think down below. But the same thing applies with the titanium-coated blade. It's essentially going to have enhanced edge life, better edge retention. It's going to be able to withstand the game, the general wear and tear that you get throughout a game a little bit better than steel that doesn't have any type of particular coating on it. And just from generally what I know about runners, I will say that Bauer's runner in this particular instance will have a little bit more advantages over the black runner that we see from CCM Skate. So strictly looking at this from a point system, you can go ahead and add 1 point for Bauer in this area over here. Now, as we move up from there, looking at the holders that both of these skates have. With the AS3 Pro, CCM are using their XS holder, which has that dial that allows you to switch out your steel without any tools whatsoever. You just scroll the dial to pop the blade out, scroll the dial to pop the blade back in. Bauer are using their LS Edge holder, which has the trigger that you use to be able to pop the steel in and out. Now, although these holders are also referred to as toolless, anyone that's had any experience with an LS Edge holder knows that you have to squeeze that trigger very, very hard. Bauer also provide a little tool that allows you to pop the runner out from the heel that comes inside the skate box. It's not something that you necessarily need, but in some cases you do have to put a lot of force onto the blade to get it to pop out, and then you have to put a lot of force onto the blade to get it to pop in. So if we're looking at it from a convenience perspective, hands down here, the XS holder from CCM wins over here. I think it not only secures the blade in a much more secure fashion, so you have less pop-outs, any instances of blades being able to pop out. To my recollection, I've not had or heard of anyone having a blade pop out of the XS holder, but I've seen countless blades popping out of Bauer's LS Edge. So that's just food for thought. CCM wins a point over here. So far, it's 1-1 between both of these brands. Now, from there, moving up into where these skates get very interesting, and that's going to be the quarter package. This is where we're obviously going to start with the outsole, as we always do. With the outsole over here, looking at the Ultrasonic Skates in this case, they're using what Bauer referred to as a unibody construction, which is essentially, I'm referring it to, I know it's not exactly accurate, but I'm referring it to as a bit of a hybrid between a one-piece construction and a two-piece skate. Now, although the Ultrasonic Skate is still very much a two-piece constructed skate, that unibody construction where the outsole comes up much higher into the quarter package and heel area of the skate has a few benefits. It's going to help to increase the general durability of the lower ends or the lower section section of the skate's quarter package, as well as the outsole itself. So those areas are going to have a little bit more enhanced durability. And it could be argued that this is going to also help to add a little bit of stability to the skate. Now, when we look at CCM's outsole on the AS3 Pro, that is using CCM's one-piece boot construction. Now, the one-piece boot construction has numerous benefits over two-piece construction. Because you eliminate the presence of the outsole itself, which is a separate piece of composite material that has to be attached to the body of the skate or the boot in this case, you're eliminating the actual composite material of the outsole itself, you're eliminating the glue, the clips, and the pins that are holding the outsole in place to the body of the skate. So this is not only going to make the skate lighter by quite a margin, it's also going to help to make the skate more responsive and help to also increase the energy transfer that goes through the skate. So essentially, there's less material that your motions or the energy from your foot has to go through to be able to reach the blade of the skate. So anything that you're doing inside the skate is able to be translated more efficiently and effectively directly to the blade, to the ice, resulting in a much more responsive skate. So when we look at that versus a two-piece construction with an outsole, that's where you have the advantage, that's where you have the edge over the traditional way the skates were constructed. Aside from that, the one-piece construction also allows the boot to be significantly stiffer. Anything that's more rigid is gonna definitely help those big, powerful players or just powerful players in general, which means, again, it's gonna be a more durable skate. So in this area over here, in terms of the outsole and the one-piece construction, if you're looking at it from a point perspective, another point goes to CCM over here. So now at the minute, we're looking at 2-1 CCM against Bauer. Now moving up into the rest of the quarter package of both of these skates. Now, when we look at Bauer's quarter package, it still features what is referred to in the skate world as non-performance components, which are essentially any materials that are attached to a skate that don't benefit the skate's actual performance. And what I mean by this is the actual Bauer logo being on the side, which is, you know, you could refer to it as glued or stitched, or it's a separate piece of material that is attached to the body of the skate. This is present in also the heel section of Bauer's ultrasonic skates and also around the eyelet sections as well. When we look at CCM's AS3 Pro skate, essentially everything on the body of the skate is there to benefit its performance. All the non-performance components have been stripped away, and all of the logoing, branding on the skate is actually sublimated onto the actual body of the skate itself. So there isn't anything here attached that doesn't need to be there. This also is present in the eyelet section of the skates, which are also part of that one-piece construction. Whereas when we look at Bauer's eyelet system on the ultrasonic skates, this embodies or encompasses more of the traditional method with eyelets. Although this is referred to as flex facing, and it does have benefits in terms of allowing the skate to help the player or aid the player being able to take a long, deep stride. So if you're that type of player that takes those long, deep, powerful strides, the flex facing that the skate has around the eyelet section, the cut of the boot, the shape of the boot, all benefits you towards those kind of properties over there, or that type of skating style, you could say. But this isn't to say that that inhibits players from being able to achieve the same result in the CCM AS3 Pro skates. But these are just two different ways that these different manufacturers are adding features to their skates to specifically target their skates at one particular type of player versus another. But it is important to mention that the ultrasonic skate is using a much more traditional eyelet system around the top section of the skate's quarter package, whereas CCM, because it's that one-piece skate construction, it still encompasses that entire one-piece idea where even the space around the eyelets is the same as the actual body of the boot itself, because that entire section of the skate is one piece. But the fact that CCM is using that one piece construction, it's very, very difficult to be able to give or award a point to a skate that is still technically a two piece, that still has those non-performance components, that's still essentially using a very traditional eyelet system. So over here, my opinion in this area, which is probably going to be arguable in the comment section down below, we need to give another point to CCM over here. So that's now 3-1 in terms of CCM versus Bauer. Now moving to the front of the skate and looking at the toe cap of the AS3 Pro skates from CCM. These particular toe caps are very traditional. There's nothing really unique or special going on here, aside from the fact that the way that CCM attaches the toe cap to the skate has been improved over time when we look at some of the previous models of skates from CCM. But this is a very traditional toe cap. Nothing has changed over here. Now, when we look at the toe cap on the ultrasonic skates from Bauer, the first thing you're going to notice is that it's much, much smaller, much more narrow. It's asymmetrical. What this essentially does is that it eliminates what we refer to as negative space inside a skate. Now, negative space is any room inside a skate that isn't optimal, isn't required. Toe caps for God knows how long have been so high, and I've never known why, because your toes are just bouncing around in that empty space, which doesn't really translate well to having a responsive skate on the ice. Bauer have done a very, very good job in this area over here of introducing a very low profile asymmetrical toe cap, which eliminates any unwanted or unnecessary space inside the skate. That doesn't mean it's going to be tight. It means that they've just gotten rid of any room inside the toe cap that just really wasn't required. Aside from it making the skate look much more aggressive, much sleeker, it aids the skate in being much more responsive because, again, your foot is locked in there, it's nice and snug, so any movements that you make can be translated directly onto the ice. A great comparison or analogy here might be trying to run, jump, and climb in a pair of shoes that are very, very big versus running, jumping, and climbing in a pair of shoes that fit your feet very snug. There's going to be a very difference in how quick and reactive you can be. Same thing on the skates. So Bauer have definitely done a good job here. In addition to this, they've also attached some carbon fiber to the toe cap itself, helping to aid the skate with durability, with lightness, and let's be honest, I'm not going to lie, it looks pretty sick too. So if we're looking at this again from a points perspective, this gives Bauer an extra point over CCM in this particular area over here, bringing us up to a total of 3-2. Now from there, moving on to the tongues of both of these skates. Now this is where things can get a little bit tricky, especially when we look at the inside of the skate and the fit of these skates. That's going to be a different story, but we'll come to that shortly. Now when we look at the tongue on the ultrasonic skates from Bauer's Supreme range, this is their Reflex Pro tongue. Now, again, this tongue works tandem with that flex-facing eyelet system or that cut of the boot, and also the reflex tendon on the rear of the skate. All of these three components of the skate work in allowing players to be able to get a full leg extension, a deep stride. Essentially, the mechanics of this skate has been built to allow players to really get that deep, powerful, long stride out of these skates. And the tongue is there to help all of this take place on the ice. Now, when we look at the general construction of the tongue, the protection, how stiff the tongue is, how much flexion there is, and how much it's able to spring back when you push it forward, you can clearly see that all of this is there to aid the skater in being able to maximize on their stride. Now, with Bauer's tongues, this isn't something that you can switch out. You can't remove any inserts over here. When we look at CCM's tongue featured on the AS3 Pro skates, what they're doing over there is allowing players to have the option between essentially three different tongues. They're able to have a tongue that is very, very thin and 4 millimeters, which is incredibly thin. Players can also choose a 7 millimeter tongue, which features D3O foam. Bearing in mind, their tongues are also asymmetrical, which isn't something that's present on the Bauer skates. Essentially, the asymmetrical cut is just more in tune with the shape of your foot. It just allows it to wrap better around your foot. So again, this is how CCM's tongues are designed to help you take that full stride, to help you get that full leg extension. The asymmetrical design definitely helps in this element. It stops the tongue from slipping and sliding to the side, as we see with a lot of tongues. The asymmetrical design element isn't something that's present on Bauer's tongue, and I'm not saying it's something that's going to hinder them. It's just two different ways that these two manufacturers have decided to do things. They also have a 7 millimeter thick tongue that has the D3O material that we've referenced in a lot of videos. Very protective, very lightweight. Like, the protection properties this material has is insane. I'll link videos down below in the video description if you want to find out more about this revolutionary foam. But there is also a 10 millimeter foam from CCM, which again features the D3O material. In addition to being able to offer players the option to select which tongue best fits their ability and their skating style on the ice, in terms of you play very high level hockey, you're blocking shots, go for the most protective to keep you safe on the ice, and vice versa, being able to switch out to a thin tongue if maybe you're playing recreationally without contact or checking. Lots of different options aside from the comfort element that these tongues provide. But these tongues also allow the player to be able to adapt the volume inside the skate. So when we look at the AS3 Pro skate from CCM, as we know, it's a wider construction skate than the JetSpeed range of skates from CCM. So this is a line of skates that traditionally you could compare to the Supreme range from Bauer. They kind of fitted the same type of player, very roughly. Now, what we're able to do here is in the forefoot area, if you go for a thin tongue, you increase the amount of volume in that area. So if you have a foot that requires more volume in this area, but you want to be able to wear this particular skate, you're able to adapt the tongues based on how much volume you need. And if you go for a 10 millimeter thick tongue, for example, you're able to reduce the amount of volume inside the skate. So if you may have needed to go for a JetSpeed skate because that has less volume, by adding the 10 millimeter thick tongue into the AS3 Pros, which is the SuperTax range of skates from CCM, you're able to decrease the volume, perhaps giving you a better fit. So this is a very unique way that CCM have allowed players to be able to adapt the volume in the forefoot area of the skates. Of course, if you wanted to adapt the volume in the heel section of the skates, that's when you perhaps needed to look at a different range of skates or a different family, like the JetSpeed or the Ripcore. Now, looking at Bauer's tongue, this isn't something that allows you to do that, but Bauer have been able to achieve the same result by using the new fit system that they've created, Fit 1, Fit 2, Fit 3, which I'm not going to go into because there's a lot of information there, and I'll link the video that explains it in great detail down below in the video description, as well as the podcast that also goes into much, much more detail. But that gives you a quick example of what these two manufacturers have done with their tongues. That was a lot. What am I on time wise?
20 minutes.
Now, if we're looking at it from a points perspective, it's very tricky to be able to say which system is better than another. Bauer's tongue is great, but you can't change them. CCM's tongue is great. You can flip between different tongues, change the volume inside the skate, but it's very difficult to compare them. So I'm going to set this as a draw. If we're looking at it from a technological perspective, which tongue has the more advancements as a tongue in its own, CCM does get that credit. But if you're looking at it from a perspective of which one is going to benefit players, you know, globally, it's debatable. So I'm going to set that as a draw, leaving us still on 3-2 to CCM. Now from here, we're going to look at the tendons of both of these skates. Now, straight away, the first thing that you're going to notice is Bauer's tendon on the ultrasonic skate is weird. It's funky, it looks alien, but as I mentioned earlier on in the video, that tendon is the reflex tendon, and it's there to be able to help players with that full, deep stride leg extension. We've talked about this already in the video. I personally like the way it looks. I know some players aren't really too fond of the way it looks. And they think that it's gonna like kind of, like JJ and Tommy were explaining how they felt like it was really pushing in the back of their legs. I don't really think that that's gonna be an issue on the ice, you know, speaking frankly after trying on these skates and having spent a little bit of time with them. And CCM's tendon is a very traditional tendon. There's nothing really unique going on over here. It's as you'd expect from a skate of this sort of level. It does what it's supposed to do. It doesn't inhibit you from being able to stride or skate. So again, this is a bit of a catch-22. I do like the kind of technology that's been included into Bauer's tendon. And again, if we're looking at it from a technological point of view, which one has the better tech, Bauer would win the point. But again, it's arguable. It's, you know, it's questionable which one is really going to benefit players long-term, which one players are going to like. So I'm stuck here, guys, so I'm going to go for another draw. So we're still at 3-2 to CCM. Now, you could say that we're at, technically, what does that make us? 5-3, we could say, potentially, but we'll just say 3-2 because it's still a draw. No points awarded there. Yeah? Cool? What? You've got something to say?
I'd say that the Bauer tongue would be better. There's more tech going into it, like, to be as fair as you possibly can. With the tongues, that was a tricky one, because obviously you can switch the tongues out there, but then you don't have the fit system that Bauer has. And so obviously if you've got that fit system, you don't need to be changing tongues out, do you?
That's yeah, the whole point. I wouldn't normally leave a section like this in this video, but I'm going to leave it in there.
That's the whole point of the fit systems.
Yeah, he has a point. Okay, fine. So now that brings us up to 3-3.
Yeah, 3-all.
Okay, 3-all. Let me know in the comments, guys. I would normally cut this bit out of the video, but he had a point. And this probably lets you know how much we've been talking about skates over the last couple of weeks, because Ricky doesn't play hockey, Ricky doesn't skate. So the fact that he knows so much now is actually funny. But let me know in the comment section down below if you agree. We'll go 3-3. So now we're at a draw. Interesting. So from there, moving up into the neck of the skate, both of these skates have their own version of comfort pads, which is the soft cushioning around the neck of the skate to stop it from digging in or cutting into the side of your foot. Having used these skates, put them on, the AS3 Pro, in my opinion, their comfort pad is softer. I also like the material that it's made from. It's more rubbery than a synthetic leather that is featured on the ultrasonic skates from the Bauer Supreme range. So it's a little one, but I think that does make a big difference when you're on the ice for, you know, 3-4 sessions during the week. If you're on the ice for multiple hours a day, that really does take its toll, and having a very soft comfort pad on the neck of the skate goes a long way. So in this particular area, I'm going to award that point to CCM. That brings us up to a score of 4 to CCM, 3 to Bauer. Now, when we move into the inside of these skates, both of these skates are using their own different types of foams and liners and materials to keep players comfortable and manage moisture inside these skates. They're both elite level skates, so we can always expect to find the best materials in here. With the liners with the Bauer ultrasonic skates, they're using the LockFit Pro liners, which has all of the tech and foam padding that you'd expect from a skate at this level. When we look at CCMs, it's using the Total Dry Pro Plus liners. They're very, very comparable, but to keep arguments short and sweet, this particular instance over here, CCM's materials inside the skate and the padding that they've used, in multiple people's opinion, is better in the CCM AS3 Pros. That's us collectively trying all of these skates on and seeing which one felt the most comfortable. Bauer's skates, in this case the ultrasonics, do have great foam liners. The lining and foams inside the ultrasonic skates is definitely better than what we saw in the previous generation from the Bauer Supreme range. But as it stands right now, the AS3 Pros have much softer, much more comfortable foams and pads inside the skate's liners than the ultrasonics. But again, this is very debatable, but in this particular case, CCM wins one in this area over Bauer. That takes the score up to 5-3 if you're still keeping track. Now, last but not least, that leads us on to the fit of both of these skates. As I've said previously, traditionally, the SuperTax, in this case, the AS3 Pro, would have been a very good kind of comparison in terms of the volume inside the skate and the particular fit that the skate has when we compared it directly to Bauer's line and we looked at the Supreme family from Bauer's line. Similar color, similar fit system. But that completely goes out the window now because, as we know, Bauer introduced a brand new fit system. Fit 1, Fit 2, Fit 3, which could be thought of, for example, Fit 1 being the Vapor family, Fit 2 being the Supreme family, Fit 3 being the Nexus family, or Nixus as I love to say. This essentially means that the one Supreme skate that we have over here, which is the Ultrasonic, is able to offer players a much broader selection or range of fits than the previous generation of Supreme skates that we've ever seen, or than this particular CCM AS3 Pro skate that we're looking at. So with the CCM AS3 Pro skate, the fit of this skate would be considered to have medium volume. So if you're looking at it against a jet speed, for example, like FT2, it would be slightly wider and have a little bit more volume than this particular skate and also be much stiffer. So when we look at altering the fit of the AS3 Pro Skate from the CCM SuperTax range, you have the different sizes, size 7, size 8, size 9, to change the length of the skate, and you've got D and E to change the width of the skate, and I mentioned the different tongues that CCM have allow you to select the volume in just the forefoot of the skate. You have three different tongues to either increase the volume or decrease the volume in only the forefoot of the skate. If you needed to adapt the volume of the skate in any other area, you had to look at another family or range of skates. For example, the Ripcore or the Jet Speed. Now with Bauer's Ultrasonic skate from the Supreme range, with Fit 1, 2, 3, Bauer has three different volume ranges that this skate is able to offer different players with different foot shapes, all within the Supreme skate. Although they don't allow you to switch out the tongue, they have three different fits that cater to three different types or different types of foot shapes that are out there. In my opinion, this new fit system that Bauer have introduced is something that I see other skate manufacturers possibly looking at, also jumping on board with. From the surface of what we've seen, from what I've tried on, this fit system makes much, much more sense than using the options of D, E, double E, and also, of course, adapting the skate's volume by going to a different family of skates. Because as we know, if we're looking at CCM skates, Jet Speed and the SuperTax, these skate families have different features that facilitate different types of players that have different advantages over different other skates. But that means that if your foot only fits in a Jet Speed or only fits in a SuperTax range, you're limiting yourself to the features of that particular skate if they aren't the ones that are going to be best for your type of level of performance and your style of play. Of course, you can go custom and then eliminate that need, but if that isn't an option for you based on the increase in price or the wait time that you have when you order a pair of custom skates, being able to walk into a retail store and pick the exact skate that you want based on the fit options that that manufacturer has now introduced to their skates definitely wins a point here. So in terms of the fit of these skates, I have to give a point to Bauer in this area because this new fit system, I think, is groundbreaking. And I've said it multiple times before. I'm very interested to see how other manufacturers respond to it. So that brings the score up to 5-4, still in favor of CCM from a tech perspective. But like I said, seriously impressed with this new fit system from Bauer. And I'm really interested to get players' feedback once these skates launch globally and more players are able to try them out. But if you want more information on the fit system, video down below and also podcast down below where we go into much more detail explaining it. Now this brings us to the end of the video. Hopefully this has helped to shed light onto number one, why this is such a tricky video to make, because it is very opinion based and very, you know, kind of like player preference orientated. What I prefer is going to have a massive impact on which skate wins this battle. But in the comment section, comment down below all of the different categories that we've gone through that I will list down below. Let me know which one gets a point for you and why, so we can see, you know, globally what you guys would pick based on the tech in these skates and also the fit. But thank you for watching this video all the way to the end. We've also got the Ultrasonic versus the 2S skates coming very, very soon. Very soon, just bear with us to get that video ready. But as always, guys, thumbs up the video, subscribe so you can stay up to date with everything that we post, and comment down below with what video you would like to see next. Thanks for watching, guys, and take care till next time. This has been a tricky one, but hopefully you understand where we're coming from. Peace.